channel. Today I'm talking about a hot topic. I'm talking all about peels. So if it's something you're interested in and passionate about, make sure to like and subscribe, especially if you love the content. Please leave comments if you want to learn or hear about something new. Today I'm specifically going to be talking about products to use and what to do post peel. You can see, well, I don't know if you can tell or not, but I do not have any makeup on today. I just had a peel 8 days ago, and I wanted you to see the incredible results I've gotten. I did a no downtime peel, which means there was no redness or actual peeling associated with it. I did a 30% total peel. And I do very specific things after having a peel done to help the process because, you know, make sure also too, one thing I want to call out, when you're having peels done, please, if unless you're professional, do not do these at home. I see a lot of peels on the market, on Amazon, in different places. There's different peels and the solutions. You're not sure if they're trustworthy. You want to make sure that they're a skin-friendly, healthy peel. So do make sure you're seeing a professional. I can't stress how important that is. So an esthetician, a doctor, an RN, a plastic surgeon, whoever's doing the peel for you. And follow their post-care recommendations. But I just want to share the stuff I love to do personally and products that are my absolute go-tos anytime I do any type of peel. First thing I want to talk about is, you know, make sure that you're taking care of your skin. So you want to use the right, really nice hydrating serums, moisturizers. If I do something more invasive, that's where I'm actually getting shedding or peeling, I like to use, this product is from Hydropeptide. It's their soothing balm. I mean, you can see it's almost empty. I use it for so many things. It's 100% organic coconut oil. There's arnica in here. It helps with that wound and bruise healing process. So if I do ever experience any shedding, I like to apply this. It's an oil, and I mean, even today, I'm gonna rub it all over my face because, you know, I did have a peel about a week ago. It's incredibly nourishing, it's hydrating, it helps to prevent you from picking. So if you do actually get shedding like a snake, do not pick. That will cause scarring. You need to make sure you have a product that if you find yourself going to pick something, make sure to slather on that moisturizer or balm or whatever it is that you're using. Absolutely, number one important thing is make sure you're using a sunscreen, something with a stronger SPF of a 30 or a 50 or a 70, depending on how strong of a peel you did. Make sure it is a mineral sunscreen and not a chemical blocker. So key ingredients to look for are zinc and titanium dioxide. Those are your physical sunblockers, super healthy for your skin and your skin cells. A couple of them that I have here, Kula is a really nice one. It's a beautiful organic line. Sometimes I like something a little bit stronger. I have a nice one here by PCA Skincare. It's a broad spectrum SPF 40. Another SPF 50 from Hydropeptide. Both are your mineral sunscreens. Going to give you a little bit of that stronger coverage. And they both have beautiful ingredients in there that are going to help nourish the skin as well. So skin healthy ingredients that you want to look for. And then I don't wear a lot of makeup after doing a peel unless I have to, if I'm going out for work or a meeting or something like that. So the two products I definitely go for, depending on what you like, if you like a powder or a cream base. If you like that liquid base, one that I really like is one by Color Science. You can see mine is almost empty. It's an SPF 30. Again, this one has skin healthy ingredients. So not only is it makeup, it doesn't have a lot of fillers in there and artificial fragrances. You wanna look for products that are more medical grade, especially after doing a peel. So again, this is your broad spectrum. It's gonna give you coverage. It has a nice tint to it, so you're gonna get that beautiful coverage to cancel out any redness in the skin. It is one of my personal favorites. I tend to use it almost daily, not even just post peel. Another product that I like, I definitely recommend a mineral makeup post peeling. This is so healing, incredible for the skin. I prefer La Belladonna. They're just a beautiful collection. It's super high quality minerals. I know there's a lot of mineral makeups out there on the market, but one that I can personally stand behind and recommend is La Belladonna. Really high quality. It naturally has an SPF in there because it has the zinc and titanium. When you are using it, make sure you have a kabuki brush. It's really gonna help with the distribution on the skin. It's gonna give you a beautiful, flawless coverage application. It's just the bristles are very firm and compact. So I like to just kind of put it in my lid, I'll knock it out, and then rub it on the skin. And it just, it's so beautiful. I love it. You can really layer it and play, so for your desired coverage. So for one swipe, you're just gonna get a light coverage, and you can certainly layer if you need something stronger. Again, this is a makeup I use on a daily basis, not just post-peeling. Super high quality, beautiful ingredients. I can go on and on and on about stuff to do post-peeling, but these are just a couple of key products that I highly recommend after having a peel. I will do another episode on just peels and what to look for in the different blends. So stay tuned. I'll make sure to put a link below. One thing I definitely want to add when you're looking to do peels, the best time of the year is really in your winter and fall months when you're not going to be exposed to a lot of sunlight. So that's really the time I recommend to start considering doing some peels, whether they're mild, just beautiful resurfacing treatment, or more invasive, like your Jesner's or even IPL treatment. You really want to do your peels in the fall and winter months, definitely not in the summertime. Ideal months are the fall and winter. If you like this video, make sure to like and subscribe and follow and share. Thank you for joining me today, and happy peeling.